souls. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a sign that He wants us to win. And how do we win? Allah says it in the verse that I commenced with, that the person who obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the person who follows the path of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are the winners. So we need to take the month of Ramadan to analyze ourselves, that how close are we getting to following as much as possible from the teachings of Allah and that of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So as we conclude the month of Ramadan, we need to remind ourselves that we do not conclude the month, rather we conclude our lives with the actions of the month. We don't conclude the month of Ramadan. We rather conclude our lives with the actions and the a'mal of Ramadan. And this is one lesson that we can learn from the conclusion of the month of Ramadan, is that our lives will also come to an end and a conclusion. Our temporary abode here is going to come to an end. So the conclusion of Ramadan should remind us about our own end and our own conclusion. And therefore, this should motivate us to do much better in following Allah and the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a famous report, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ. Actions are judged based on their conclusions. It's very easy, and I'm sure you'll agree with me, it's very easy to start something, but to actually conclude it, it's more difficult. We all have ambitions and we say we want to do this, we want to lose weight, I want to write a book, I want to, you know, take a course. So it's very easy to enroll, to start, to engage, but then after a week, after 2 weeks, after a month, after 5 months, after 6 months, are we still engaged? So the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِيمِ, that actions are judged based on their conclusions. So when we conclude the month of Ramadan, we should conclude strong. We should conclude with the best of our practice during these final moments of the month of Ramadan. Sufyan al-Thawri, rahimahullah, was weeping in the night. It was Qiyam. He was doing Qiyam, he was standing in prayer, and he was weeping profusely. He was tearing, his beard got wet, the space where he was praying was wet. That's how much he wept. So someone asked him, أَخَوْفًا مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ? The whole night you wept, is it because you fear your sin? And at that moment, Sufyan al-Thawri, he saw a straw, a piece of grass, a straw. It barely fit in his finger. That's how minute and small it was. So he told the person that when it comes to sin, it's less significant than this. What he meant is that if we've sinned, we make tawbah, we ask Allah for forgiveness, and Allah is most merciful, He will forgive us. The reason I wept is I fear su'il khatima. I fear an evil end. And the Prophet ﷺ taught us that we should always make dua for a beautiful end. For a beautiful end, a beautiful conclusion. You know, I envy these individuals who are passing away in the month of Ramadan. I envy them. Because this is the best time to pass away. Where the gates of the hellfire are shut, they're closed. And the gates of paradise are open. The ulama have written, a person who passes away in the month of Ramadan, it's a sign they are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are forgiven. So the point I'm making is that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, taught us that we should conclude our lives with the best of deeds, and we can only do this if we're committing to our good deeds every single day. If we're reciting Quran every day, the day we pass away, we have recited Quran. If we give charity every day, the day we pass away, we have given charity. If we speak the truth every single day, then the day we have passed away, we have spoken the truth. If we're praying and punctual with our prayer every single day, then the day we pass away, we have prayed as well. So we need to conclude our lives, and Ramadan is a sign that we can do it. If we can do something in Ramadan, for sure we can do it outside Ramadan as well. And we should have firm hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should never ever feel, you know, I wasted Ramadan, so why finish Ramadan with something extra? No, even if we haven't done anything in the month of Ramadan, the few moments that remain, be positive about it. This is exactly what the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, taught us. There's an incident that is recorded in the hadith during the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where someone straight away, Abdullah ibn Sa'd ibn Abi Sarh radiyallahu anhu, he actually was the scribe, he was the katib, he was one of the scribes for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would write down the wahi. What an honor. He was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was doing work for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, nay, for the Quran, for the Muslims. It so happened, according to the narrations, that he strayed away. According to some of the narrations, فَأَلْحَقَ بِالْكُفَّارِ, he renounced Islam and he joined the ranks of the kuffar, the disbelievers. He became a murtad. And it so happened that after some years, he was inspired to the truth. He was inspired. He made tawbah and he came back to Islam. He lived even after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they mentioned that one of his du'as was, he wanted a great end, husnul khatima, because he felt very bad of those few years where he was away from Islam. So how did his death occur? Subhanallah, a death to envy. He was leading prayer. He was leading a group of Sahaba and Tabi'un in Salah. He did the first rak'ah. He did the second rak'ah. Now he's in his final tashahud and he's reciting dua. He makes salam, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, on the right. Before he could conclude the last salam, his death occurred. He passed away in salah, in prayer. So here's a man who renounced Islam. Here's a man who turned away from the truth after being blessed. Nay, he was so close to the Prophet ﷺ that he was the katib. He was one of those who was the scribes for the Prophet ﷺ. But when he saw the truth, and he was inspired with the truth, he made tawbah, and he came back to the ways of the teachings of Islam. And Allah blessed him with a beautiful death. So this is a sign, and Ramadan is also a sign that there's always hope, because at the conclusion of Ramadan, what happens is the blessed day of Eid. And it's forbidden. You cannot fast on the day of Eid. It's haram to fast on the day of Eid, because we're supposed to express our joy, kulu washrabu, and enjoy the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, Ramadan also teaches us to be hopeful for the future, just like Ramadan concludes with the day of Eid, a day of happiness and joy. If we lead our lives with positive works, with great actions, and good, just being good human beings and following whatever we can of the teachings of Allah and the Prophet ﷺ, then for sure we will have a husnul khatima, we'll have a winning conclusion. So we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala empower us with the ability to always strive for the best. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our good deeds in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayers. May Allah remove the difficulties of everyone who is suffering, wherever they may be. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best in this world and the hereafter. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. At this point, I'm inviting one of the board members, Brother Abdul Mateen, to read the announcements, inshallah. Jazakallah khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, with your help, IFT collected $3,947 last Friday. We thank you for your contributions, and we appreciate that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you for making a difference in our community, as well as the volunteers that are assigned for line collection. I ask that they please proceed now. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower His mercy and blessings upon you and your loved ones this Ramadan. Please note the following. Don't forget to pay fitrah for your loved ones. The minimum is $8 per person as soon as possible. That enables us to distribute it right away. Please note that fitrah has to be paid before the end of Ramadan, which is fast approaching. Fidya is $10 per day. We're also requesting all to please extend full cooperation to the volunteers and to the staff so that we can serve you better. This is a blessed month, and it's also quite busy at this time of year, so please exercise patience, inshallah. As usual, we have parking arrangements at IFT's buildings, as well as at Estate Banquet Hall directly across the street. And further to that, once again, IFT management is requesting all the congregants, please do not park at Leon's. Alhamdulillah, IFT has acquired a new Dodge Caravan for funeral services, as mentioned in previous weeks, with a generous donation received from everybody here. So far, we've collected $16,000. They're still short $14,000 to cover the entirety of the cost. Please be part of this worthy project by donating any amount that you can towards the cost of the van for funeral services. Also, please note that the 50th anniversary for IFT, Islamic Foundation's 50th anniversary, has now been set for Sunday, September 22nd. It will be at Markham Convention Center. Posters are available outside, as well as posting is on the website. We are looking for sponsors, so please, if you are interested, approach the office and we can handle your request there. The annual community carnival will be taking place on June 22nd, right here on the grounds of the Islamic Foundation. We're bringing back the Ferris wheel, other big rides, food festival, and much more. Please join us for the Eid and Canada Day celebrations. We're looking for bazaar and food vendors and volunteers for this event. If interested, please visit IFT Youth on social media or send an email to carnival@islamicfoundation.ca. Inshallah, this year on October 11th and 12th, the annual Youth Tarbiyah Conference, which has been a staple event in our community, has for more than a decade, is returning. We're currently looking for individuals and businesses to sponsor this event. Again, if you're interested, please email youth@islamicfoundation.ca. Or visit Youth Tarbiyah Conference on Facebook and Instagram. Again, in light of recent shootings in the mosque in New Zealand a few months ago, Islamic Foundation has been taking security measures, including the potential for including additional exits in the front of the prayer hall here. We are appealing to all community members to donate generously for that. And as everyone must know by now, the Khatm al-Quran is tonight, right here at Islamic Foundation, and this will be the blessed night to support the Islamic Foundation of Toronto. There will be a short fundraiser, and we can hear the Hufad and the Imam reciting the final verses of the Quran. Please join us in supplication to meet the community. The completion of the Quran is a blessed time where the angels descend. Prayers are accepted and du'as are accepted and forgiveness attained. So please come pray with us. Once again, it's tonight. At 10:35 is Salat al-Isha. Arrive with your family and friends. Arrive early, carpool if you can, to avoid all of the parking hassle. We also serve full iftar and suhoor. Inshallah, there will be three Eid Salahs this year for the first time at IFT, depending on the sighting of the moon, either June 4th or June 5th. The three timings will be 6 a.m., 7 a.m., or 8:30 a.m. We are requesting all congregants to make dollar-a-day pledges and get pledge forms from the office, desk, or in the front of the prayer hall. Let's pray, inshallah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his mercy upon our brothers and sisters, elders and children who are in distress around the world. Ameen. Please switch off your cell phones and stand up, as we are quite crowded and packed today, so that we can form the safs, and then we can sit down to listen to the remaining portion of the khutbah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
Please have a seat. Jazakallah khairan for everybody standing and sitting. Jazakallah khairan.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي وفقنا لعباداته في رمضان من الصوم والصلاة وتلاوة القرآن وأفاض علينا من بركاته والرضوان أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الحنان المنان وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله المبعوث إلى كافة الإنس والجان صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ما دارت القمران أما بعد فيا معشر الإخوان قد دخل ختام خير الزمان زمان الأنوار والبركات والرضوان أعني شهر رمضان فطوبى لمن فاز فيه بنعم الآخرة ورضي الرحمن ألا من أوتي خيرا منه فلا ينسى الخير بعده لا سيما الصلاة والحج فإن أداء الفرائض فريضة وأما من فات منه شيء من الصيام فليقضه بعده ومن أفطر فيه بلا عذر فليكفر سيئته ومن لم ينل منه شيئا فليبكي ندامة وحسرة واعلموا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال كان كصيام الدهر ألا واعلموا أن صدقة الفطر واجبة على كل مسلم حر مالك النصاب وهو نصف صاع من بر أو صاع من تمر أو شعير أو غيرها أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه وهو خير الرازقين بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآية والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف رحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا أما بعد فيا أيها الناس أوصيكم ونفسي أولاً بتقوى الله والمواظبة على ذكر الله ألا خير الكلام كلام الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وخير الأمور عوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة وقال تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد
وعلى آل سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأحياهم عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله، وعلمهم بالحلال والحرام معاذ بن جبل، وأقرأهم لكتاب الله أبي بن كعب، وأفرضهم زيد بن ثابت، ولكل أمة أمين، وأمين هذه الأمة أبو عبيدة بن الجراح رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم. اللهم اخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. استقيموا واعتدلوا. Please straighten your lines, stand close together, fill up all the gaps, ensure that the heels are on the line. If you see any